Welcome to another episode of Wildcat TV.
Today we're going to start out with a Poetry Out Loud event.
And then we're going to give you some sports segments.
As well as introduce French Week.
And also give you our very first mannequin challenge video.
And to finish things off, we got our teacher segments.
We do ask that you have a wonderful day today. And
Wildcats, do something you're proud of today. Wildcats, do something you're proud of today.
Alright?
Yes!
Just start them to sing and to tackle the thing that should be done. And they do it.
A sudden raid from the hall. By three doors left unguarded, they enter my castle wall. They climb up into my turret or the arms and back of my chair.
I woke up that morning and the time the letter came. A tired sorrow. Like an old
17 years old, we are overcome by it all. The sap is champagne. It goes to our head. We talk a lot.
How do you feel about being on stage performing your poems?
It's nerve-wracking.
Yeah. Nerve-wracking.
But once you finish a poem, you feel accomplished.
Yeah,
so.
There you go.
Yeah, oh yeah, definitely. You get up there and you just kind of like, you have that moment where you feel like, oh snap, I forgot my poem. And you're just like so nervous and you're seeing all these people here and stuff. But once you start getting really into it, and plus one of the contestants told me, like, just look at the wall back there.
This is Wildcat TV.
What's up, Wildcats? It's Ian and Nina back again for another sports update for Wildcat TV. Congratulations to our cross-country team.
Great job, Wildcats.
They did really good at states and they held their own, so keep it up and we'll do better next season.
And to our volleyball girls, great job making it all the way to the state semis. Playing at Maryland College Park, woof woof. y'all did great, and it was a great season, and hopefully you make it to state next year.
Yeah, we'd like to say good job to our varsity cheerleading team.
Wildcats in the rocks.
Yeah.
Woo!
Yeah.
Woo!
We'd like to say congratulations to our varsity cheerleading team for defending their title yet again at state, so good job, guys. Keep up the work, and we're going to do it again next year.
Arundel's French Honor Society wants to raise awareness International French Week, which was November 4th to November 10th. Here's some French trivia you may not know.
Let's see if you know the answers. Hey Justin, true or false? It's illegal to name a pig Napoleon in France.
I'm gonna have to go with false.
Actually, it's true. The French government considered it insulting. True or false? French toast is French.
True.
False. It was actually invented by a man named Joseph French.
Black Beatles in the city, be back immediately to confiscate the money.
Fresh girl, wow, my world.
You sent flowers, but you said you didn't receive. But you said
Mike,
you didn't
need
them. That girl is a real crowd please. Small world, all the friends know of me. Young bull living like an old geese. Quick release the cash, watch it fall slowly. Frat girl still trying to get in. Haters mad for whatever reason. Smoke in the air, binge drinking. They lose it when the DJ drops it.
Alright, go.
Do you like wildcats or llamas better?
I absolutely love wildcats, but my feelings for llamas go much deeper.
What sports did you play in high school?
I was a jack of all trades, master of none. I played field hockey, lacrosse, basketball, softball.
Favorite Halloween candy?
Snickers.
Favorite genre of music do you listen to?
Really listen to a lot of different things. Everything from country to rock to classic rock to techno to a little bit of rap.
All right, that's it.
Awesome.
Come see the Fall 1X shows. Friday at 7:30 and Saturday at 2:30. Student directed, student produced, and of course, student acted.